Hi everyone, it's Kim. Welcome back to my channel. And if you're new to my channel, welcome. So today we are going to be making a recipe by Drizzle Me Skinny, and I will always put the link below for the exact recipe. And the recipe today is cinnamon French toast bubble up, I think is the exact name. But again, I'm sure I'll have that in the title of our video here. So as I was drinking my coffee, I was just kind of sitting here getting hungry. So I thought, you know what, today might be the perfect day to go ahead and finally make this recipe. I bought the stuff for it, 2 weeks ago, and just have not had the opportunity to pull this together for you. So let me turn around and get our camera set up in the right area, and then we're gonna go ahead and throw this quick, easy recipe together. And the good thing that I like about most of her recipes are that they don't take a lot of ingredients. And it's not like you're scrambling, and 9 times out of 10, you just have to buy 1 or 2 ingredients because you already have them in your kitchen. So, okay, enough jibber jabber today. Let me turn the camera around and let's get this recipe started because I am starving. Okay, so the first thing you're gonna do is you are going to preheat your oven to 350 degrees. And let me tell you something, this is very important because there's nothing worse than getting ready to throw something in the oven and realizing you forgot to turn it on. So take a pause here and go ahead and preheat your oven 350 degrees. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to take some canned biscuits. And these are just the regular Walmart brand 7.5 ounce size biscuits. We're gonna go ahead, I'm gonna grab a plate so that I can pop those out on. No matter how much I try to make sure I have everything ready and together, I always forget 1 or 2 things. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and open up our biscuits and hope it doesn't pop. I don't know about you, but I still make that face and like cringe because I know it's gonna happen. Nope, didn't happen that time. All right, so. Try not to have to grab a. There we go. Get the second one open. Does anybody else still jump when that happens? I totally jump. All right, so let me get this next one open. I know I should just grab a spoon, but what fun would that be, right? There we go. I'm like, come on, it's gotta open. All right, so I'm just gonna dump all these out on the plate just to make them easier to work with. So we have a total of 20 biscuits, and then what we're going to do is we're going to cut these into 6. I'm just going to move our eggs out of the way here because we don't need those right now. Make sure I've got a good, there we go. So this is how I do it. You always need a good pair of kitchen shears. I know I've said this plenty of times on my other videos. So cut it in half and then just cut this one into 3s. And we're going to continue on. Again, cut this one in half, cut each of them into 3s. Now, I'm not gonna bore you with cutting up 20 of these, so as soon as I get these done, I will come back and we will see what the next step is. Okay, this is our last one, and if you just heard, our oven just beeped, so it's ready to go, so I need to get a move on. All right, so we have our 20 biscuits cut into 6 small pieces. So those are ready to go. Now the next thing we need to do is grab a bag. So you're gonna need like a, probably a gallon size baggie. My baggies were across the room. All right, so I have my gallon baggie here. I'm gonna go ahead and spray my pan so I don't forget to do that. right, and I'm just using just regular cooking spray, the one that I got from Costco. All right, so the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to mix 1 tablespoon of sugar and 1 heaping teaspoon of cinnamon in a bag. Open. So 1 tablespoon of sugar, 1 heaping teaspoon of cinnamon, and again, I just pick up my cinnamon at Costco just because it's I use a lot of cinnamon with my overnight oats and such. It seems like just one of those items that if you don't just buy it in big quantities, you run out of it way too easy. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna do, are you ready? We're going to put the dough pieces into the bag and we are going to shake our bag to cover and coat all of this. Got to shake and separate as we go through. Okay, so seriously, I did not think that was going to cover these, but it totally is. So I'm just going to try to get some of these separated a little bit more. Make sure I use up all of that cinnamon and sugar mixture, and that looks good. All right, so next up, are you guys ready? We're gonna put the dough pieces into the dish to cover the bottom evenly. Does anybody else love the smell of cinnamon and sugar together? I totally do. I just love it. All right, so we're just gonna make sure we spread these out. Get them all spread out so we each get a nice serving size. All right, I think that's good. Does it look even? Looks pretty even, right? Okay. All right, so the next thing we're going to do, how many times am I gonna say that? Is we're going to whisk together our eggs and milk, and then we're gonna stir in some more vanilla and cinnamon. You can't go wrong with more vanilla and cinnamon, right? So we're gonna need 5 eggs, and I'm just using my sink as a garbage bowl right now, which is totally fine. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And I will clean off my counter when we're done. Just gonna give my hands a quick rinse. All right. So 5 eggs, 1/3 cup of milk, 2 teaspoons of vanilla, and 2 teaspoons of cinnamon. Okay, so the milk that I'm using today is just my unsweetened almond milk. And I'm going to need 1/3 cup of that. Now, the recipe originally calls for just normal 1% milk, but with this being 12 servings, I'm not sure if it's really gonna make a difference. This recipe, as calculated, comes out to be 4 points. I have not recalculated this. So I'm just trusting that the site is correct. And I will recalculate it based on my stuff later. If I have a chance, I will try to put it in. You definitely need a bigger bowl. All right, so I'm just going to pop that in, give it a little swish, and then switch to a bigger bowl. Hold, please. Okay, we're going to grab a different bowl here. Get this poured over in here so we're not making that big of a mess. I went ahead and cleaned off the counter because those of you who watch my channel know that was bugging me to no end. All right, so we've got that in there. The next thing we're going to add in is the vanilla. I need 2 teaspoons of vanilla. All That's one. And that's two. And I always add a little bit of extra vanilla to anything that calls for vanilla because I really like the flavor. And then 2 teaspoons of cinnamon. There we go. So we're going to mix this together. Good thing I got a bigger bowl because that would have been going all, I wouldn't have got it mixed, or B, I just would have made a huge mess. So note to self, get a bigger bowl. All right, so next thing we're gonna do is we're going to pour this over our eggs, or over our biscuits. We're gonna pour the eggs over the biscuits. Does that help? Just says to do this evenly. And that looks good. All right, so we're gonna put this in our 350 degree preheated oven for 35 minutes. Once those 35 minutes are up, stay tuned because you know what? There's icing. So as soon as I pull this out, we will come back. I will show you what it looks like. And then we will whip together our icing. And then I will finally get to enjoy my breakfast. Okay, if you're like me and you're curious, let's take a look and see. We're about 14 minutes out from this being done. Ooh. Look at that. Try to zoom you in a little bit more. It's coming along great. All right, I'm gonna shut this back and let it finish cooking. Okay, and that irritating sound will be my timer. I really should use my friend Alexa because she's definitely not as irritating. So let's get this out of the oven. Let's see how it looks. Look at that. Holy moly. Can you get a bead on that? Look at that. Let me get some light on that for you. Woo! Does that not look amazing? All right, so we're gonna switch over back to our other counter here and we're going to get our icing made and give this time to cool off just a bit. And then I will let you know how much I love this. So I will definitely try this on camera today because I know I don't do that a lot and I come back and a lot of people ask how it was. So today I'm going to give you the entire story. So stay tuned. Okay, we're in the home stretch. So I went ahead and measured out 1/3 cup of confectioner's or powdered sugar. And you know if I would have done that on camera, I would have made a huge mess. So we're just not gonna have that today. So I'm just gonna go ahead and dump that into our bowl here. Next, we're going to need 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. All right. Just gonna pour that over. And our last ingredient that we need is 1 tablespoon of milk. And again, I'm just going to use my unsweetened almond milk. I'm going to pour that in and I'm going to give this all a big stir. It says that you should pour this over the bubble up as it's warm. So we're going to go grab that really quick. And I'll get that on my counter. I'm gonna get my hot plates out. I'll tell you one thing. I never had a use for hot plates before, or I think that's what these are called. But I really never had a use for them before until I started with my YouTube channel. And it seems like now I use them all the time. Okay, so here we go. We're gonna bring this over here, set it on our trivets. That's what they're called, trivets. Hot plates. Hot plates is the thing you cook on, right? All right, I'm gonna bring you down, bring you in. There we go. And then we're going to pour this over our mixture. Try to do it this way so you can get the full visual. scrape the rest of it out because, you know, we like all that yummy goodness. All right, so I'm gonna let that sit per her instructions. It says let icing set and then cut into 12 equal servings. So we're gonna maybe pick this up and roll it around. It looks like I got a little bit more in the middle there. I definitely want to try to make sure that that is all together. And we have a little bit of icing on everything. Perfect. You know what might be cute is when we're done to sprinkle just a little tiny bit of powdered sugar on it just to make it fancy. What do you think? I bought this powdered sugar thing, powdered sugar container, shaker, powdered sugar shaker. Where are my words today? I'm starving, that's where they're at. So I bought that just because I'm always wanting to just sprinkle some things on my donuts or things like that. So I always wanted one, just really never ordered one. So a friend was having a party, so that was what I chose to order this time. So Pampered Chef, you gotta love them. I mean, they suck you in with all their fun little gadgets, don't they? All right, so give me a minute. We're gonna let this sit for about another 5 minutes and then I'll come back and let you know my thoughts. Okay, we've got our French toast bubble up, cinnamon French toast bubble up. I don't know why I can't get that down, but we're gonna go ahead and give this a try on camera. This is amazing. Check it out. So good. All right, so I'm going to give this one a thumbs up because it's so good, and I'm going to sign off from here so that I can enjoy this while it's still warm. Thanks for watching. Again, if you're not subscribed to my channel, please make sure that you subscribe to my channel and like, comment, share, all that good stuff. And if you want to see more Cook With Me's, just put Cook With Me down in the comments and we will get some more videos out here for you. All right, so with that said, signing off. Have a great day. We'll see you next time. Bye.